Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us go through look scheduling. So this is almost similar to normal scan, but it will observe the future, but it will go to the end. Basically, scan will go to the end and return back when there are no further services. It will not go till the end. So that's the main thing, guys. I think I wrote a bit wrong in the definition. It's okay. Okay. So basically, now let us go through the example so that you'll be clear. Okay, so let me turn the pages. So we are continuing with the same example from the past three videos, guys. Sorry, four videos. Okay, so the initial value given is 0 and the end value is 199. Please don't write 200. Still now I am writing 200. Fine. So in between 50, 100, 150. Okay, so initially you'll be starting at 37. So 37, mark 37. After that, you reached 53. These are the two fixed movements, guys, which is given in the question directly. Okay. So after you reached 53, you traveled to the next points, right? So this is also a one directional move. You will be going till some point and you'll be returning back. Fine. Okay. So after 53, what is the greatest value? 57. After 57, it is 98. After 98, it is 122. After 120, it is 129. So once it reached 129, it will check whether there is any input future. Is there anything, guys? After 129, is there anything greater? No, there is nothing greater. So it returns back directly from then and there. So it returns back till 47. And after 47, it moves to 25. After 25, 14 to 12. So this will be your diagram. So if you want to calculate the seek time for this, okay, so calculation of seek time will be normally you'll be doing in the same way, guys. So let me just write it from the above diagram so it's clear. 53, 53 to 57, 53 to 98, 98 to 122, 122 to 129 to 47, 47 to 25, 25 to 14, 14 to 12. So you'll be calculating the differences, guys. This is the order and you'll be calculating the differences as usually. Fine. So you'll be getting a particular seek time. So here we got 209. Fine. So this is our seek time. So what are the advantages and disadvantages of this method? Advantage: it does not cause a head to move till the end. So here, if you observe, did you reach till the end? Did you waste the time movement from here to and returning back here? So we saved some time, right? So hence, look is far better than the scan algorithms. Fine. So it is better in performance, but the disadvantage is we are having more overhead because you need to check whether there is anything before or not, and we will be having long waiting time for the initial ones. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this. Basically, there will be a waiting time in any situation, guys, because even if you give priority, it could be reduced, but there is no chance to reduce it completely. Fine. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this look. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through C look, guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching.